further ado, we present to you a Midsummer Night's Dream. Nuptial hour is drawn on apace. Four happy days brings on another moon, but oh, methinks how slow this old moon wanes. She lingers my desires.
4 days will quickly steep themselves in night. 4 nights will quickly dream away the time, and then the moon, like to a silver bow, new bent in heaven, shall behold the night of our solemn.
Hippolyta, I wooed thee with my sword, and won thy love doing thee injuries, but I will wed thee in another key, with pomp, with triumph, and with reveling.
Happy be Theseus, our renowned Duke.
Thanks, good Aegeus. What's the news with thee?
Full of vexation come I. With complaint against my child, my daughter, Hermia. Stand forth, Demetrius. My noble lord, this man hath my consent to marry her. Stand forth, Lysander. My gracious Duke, this man hath bewitched the bosom of my child. With cunning hast thou filched my daughter's heart, turned her obedience, which is due to me, to stubborn harshness. My gracious Duke, be it so, that she will not hear before your grace consent to marry with this man. I beg the ancient privilege of Athens. As she is mine, I may dispose of her, which shall be either to this gentleman or to her death, according to our law.
What say you, Hermia? Be advised, fair maid, to you your father should be as a god, to whom you are but as a form in wax, by him imprinted and within his power to leave the figure or disfigure it. Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
So is Lysander.
In himself he is, but in this case, wanting your father's voice, the other must be held the worthier.
I would my father looked but with my eyes.
Rather, your eyes must with his judgment look.
I do entreat your grace to pardon me. I know not by what power I am made bold, but I beseech your grace that I may know the worst that may befall me in this case if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Either to die the death,
or to abjure forever the society of men. Therefore, fair Hermia.
Question your desires. Whether if you yield not to your father's will, you can endure the livery of a nun. But take time to pause. On the next new moon, the sealing day betwixt my love and me, on that day, either prepare to die for disobedience to your father's will, or else to wed Demetrius, as he would.
Or on Diana's altar to protest for aye austerity and single life.
Relent, sweet Hermia, and Lysander, yield thy crazed title to my right.
You have her father's love, Demetrius. Let me have Hermia's till you marry him.
Born fool Lysander. True, True. He hath my love, and what is mine, my love doth render him. And she is mine, and all my right of her I do estate unto Demetrius.
I am, my lord, as well derived as he, as well possessed. My love is more than his. My fortune's every way as fairly ranked, if not with vantage as Demetrius's. And which is more than all these boasts can be? I am beloved of beauty as Hermia. Okay. Why should not I then prosecute my right? Demetrius, I'll avouch it to his head, made love to Nestor's daughter Helena. Oh. And won her soul. And she, sweet lady, dotes, devoutly dotes, dotes in idolatry upon this spotted and inconstant man.
Yeah, I must confess I have heard so much.
Demetrius and Aegeus, go along. I have some private schooling for you both.
For you? Fair Hermia, look, you arm yourself to fit your fancies to your father's will.
Come, Hippolyta.
Oh, what cheer, my love?
With duty and desire, we follow you.
Ah! How now? My love, why is your cheek so pale? How chance the roses there do fade so fast?
Belike for want of rain, which I could well beteem them from the tempest of my eyes.
Oh, ay me. For aught that I could ever read, could ever hear by tale or history, the course of true love never did run smooth. But either it was different in blood.
Oh, cross too high to be enthralled to love?
Or else misgraft in respect of years.
Oh, spite too old to be engaged to young.
Or else it stood upon the choice of friends.
Oh, hell, to choose love by another's eyes.
Or, if there were a sympathy in choice, war, death, or sickness did lay siege to it, making it momentary as a sound.
If then true lovers have been ever crossed, it stands as an edict in destiny, then let us teach our trial patience.
A good persuasion. Therefore, hear me, Hermia. I have a widow aunt, a dowager of great revenue, and she hath no child. From Athens is her house remote 7 leagues, and she respects me as her only son. Fair, gentle Hermia, may I marry thee. And to that place the sharp Athenian law cannot pursue us. If thou lovest me, steal forth thy father's house tomorrow night, and a league without the town, there will I wait for thee.
My good Lysander, I swear to thee by Cupid's strongest bow, by his best arrow with the golden head, by all the vows that ever men have broke, in number more than ever women spoke, in that same place thou hast appointed me, tomorrow truly I will meet with thee.
Keep promise, love. Oh, look, here comes Helena.
Godspeed, fair Helena. Whither away?
Call you me fair? That fair again unsay. Demetrius loves your fair. Doe, happy fair. Sickness is catching. Doe, were favor so, yours would I catch, fair Hermia, ere I go. Teach me how you look, and with what art you sway the motion of Demetrius' heart.
I frown upon him, yet he loves me still.
Oh, your frowns would teach my smiles such skills.
The more I hate, the more he follows me.
The more I love, the more he hateth me.
His folly, Helena, is no fault of mine.
None but your beauty, would that fault were mine.
Take comfort, Helena. He no more shall see my face. Lysander, myself, shall fly this place.
Helen, to you our minds we will unfold. Tomorrow night, when Phoebe doth behold her silver visage on the watery glass, decking with liquid pearl the bladed grass, a time that lover's flight doth still conceal, through Athens' gates have we devised to steal.
And in the wood, when you and I on faint primrose beds were wont to lie, emptying our bosom of their counsel sweet, there my Lysander myself shall meet, and thence from Athens turn away our eyes and seek of new friends and stranger companies. Oh, take care, sweet playfellow, and pray thee for us, And good luck grant thee thy Demetrius.
Helena, adieu. As you on him, Demetrius dote on you.
How happy some over other some can be. Through Athens I am thought as fair as she, but what of that? Demetrius thinks not so. He will not know what all, but he do know. Love looks not with the eyes, but with the mind, and therefore is made Cupid paint and blind. For ere Demetrius ever looked on Hermia's eyne, he hailed down oaths that he was only mine. But when these hails some heat from Hermia felt, so he dissolved, and his showers of oaths did melt. I will go tell him of fair Hermia's flight. Then to the wood will he tomorrow night pursue her, and for this intelligence, if I have thanks, it is a dear expense. But here in me nigh to enrich my pain, to just have his sight thither and back again.
Scroll with every man's name, which is thought fit through all Athens to play in our interlude before the Duke and Duchess on his wedding day.
First, Madam Quince, say what the play treats on, then read the names of the actors, and so grow to a point.
Mary, our play is the most lamentable comedy and the cruel death of Pyramus and Thisbe.
A very good piece of work, I assure you, and a merry. Now, Madam Quince, call forth your actors by the scroll, and masters, spread yourselves at least 6 feet.
Answer when I call you. Nick Bottom the Weaver.
Present. Name what part I'm for and proceed.
Nick Bottom, you are set down for Pyramus.
Woo! You the man, you the... What is Pyramus? Lover or a tyrant?
A lover who kills himself most gallantly for love.
That will ask for some tears in the true performance of it. If I do it, let the audience look to their eyes, for I will move storms. Yet my chief humor is for a tyrant. I could play Hercules, really, yeah, look at these guns.
Francis Flute the Bellows Mender.
Here, Madame Quince.
You must take Thisbe on you.
What is Thisbe? A wandering knight?
Why, it is the lady that Pyramus must love.
Nay, faith, let not me play a woman. I have a beard coming in.
Oh, I have an idea. Okay, okay. Let me play Thisbe too. I'll speak in a monstrous little voice. Disney, Disney!
Ah, Pyramus, my lover dear, my Thisbe dear, and lady dear!
No, 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 you must play Pyramus and flute you Thisbe. Robin Starling, the tailor.
Here, Madam Quince.
You must play Thisbe's mother. And Tammy Snap, the tinker.
You betcha, Madam Quince.
You, Pyramus's father, myself, Thisbe's father, Snug the joiner, you the lion's part.
Have you the lion's part written? Pray you, if it be, give it me, for I am slow of study.
You may do it extempore.
Oh, okay.
It is nothing but roaring.
Okay, okay. Let me play the lion too. Okay, I'll roar that I will make the Duke, yes, 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 the Duke, say, let it roar again! Let it roar again!
And you should do it too terribly that you would fright the Duchess and the ladies, that they would shriek.
But I will aggravate my voice, that I will roar you as 20 nightingale. Okay, check out my roar first, okay? Roar.
You can play no part but Pyramus. Pyramus is, Pyramus is a sweet-faced man. A man, a proper man, as one would find in a summer's day. A most lovely, gentleman-like man. Therefore, you must needs play Pyramus.
Well, I will undertake it.
But, masters, you have your part, and I do entreat you, and request you, and desire you to con them by tomorrow night, and meet me in the palace wood a mile without the town, by moonlight. There we shall rehearse, and I pray you, fail me not.
We will meet, and there we may rehearse most obscenely and courageously. Take pains. Be perfect. Adieu. Yeah, let's get out of here. Yeah.
Seasons change, but our love went cold. Feed the flame, cause we can't let it go. Run away, but we're running in circles. Run away, run away. I dare you to do something. I'm waiting on you.
Wander you.
Over hill, over dale, through brush, through briar, over park, over pale, through flood, through fire. I do wander everywhere, swifter than the moon sphere, and I serve the fairy queen to do orbs upon her green.
Okay.
I must go seek some dewdrops here and hang a pearl in every cowslip's ear. Farewell, though, lob of spirits, I'll be gone. The queen and all her elves come here and on.
Well, no, the king doth keep his revels here tonight. Well, take heed the queen come not within his sight, for Oberon is passing fell and wrath. Oh, for she, as her attendant, hath a lovely boy stolen from a faraway king. Oh, he never had so sweet a changeling. Oh, and jealous Oberon would have the child, knight of his train, to trace the forests wild. Oh, and now they never meet in grove or green, by fountain clear or spangled starlight sheen. Oh, but they do swear that all their elves, for fear, creep into acorn cups and hide them there.
Either I mistake your shape and making quiet, or else you are that shrewd and knavish sprite, Robin Goodfellow. Are you not he that frights the maidens of villagery and sometimes makes the drink to bear no balm?
Yeah.
You mislead night wanderers laughing at their harm. Those that hobgoblin and call you sweet puck, you do their work and they shall have good luck. Are you not he?
Oh, fairy. Oh, well, thou speaks aright. Oh, I am that merry wanderer of the night. Oh, I jest to Oberon and make him smile when I a fat bean-fed horse beguile. Neighing in the likeness of a filly foal, or sometimes lurk I in a gossip's bowl in the very likeness of a roasted crab. Oh, and when she drinks, against her lips I bob. Oh, ship a room, fairy, here comes Oberon.
Oh, and here my mistress. Would that he were gone.
Ill met by moonlight, proud Titania.
What? Jealous, Oberon? Fairies, skip hence. I have forsworn his bed and his company.
Tarry, rash wanton, am not I thy lord?
Well, then I must be thy lady. But I know when thou hast stolen away from fairyland. Why art thou here? Come from the furthest steep of India, but that forsooth the bouncing Amazon, your buskined mistress and your warrior love to Theseus must be wedded. And you come to give their bed joy and prosperity.
How canst thou thus for shame, Titania, glance at my credit with Hippolyta, knowing I know thy love to Theseus?
These are the forgeries of jealousy. And never since the middle summer spring met we on hill, in dale, forest, or mead to dance our ringlets to the whistling wind. But with thy brawls hast thou disturbed our sport.
Do you amend it then? It lies in you. Why should Titania cross her Oberon? I do but beg a little changeling boy to be my henchman.
Set your heart at rest. The fairyland buys not the child of me. His mother was a votress of my order. And in the spiced evening air, full often hath she gossiped by my side. Oh, and sat with me upon Neptune's yellow sands, marking the embarked traders on the flood. When we have laughed to see the sails conceive and grow big-bellied on the wanton wind, which she, with her pretty and swimming gait following, her womb then rich with my young squire would imitate. But she, being mortal of that boy, did die. And for her sake do I rear up her boy, and for her sake I will not part with him.
How long within this wood intend you stay?
Perhaps till after Theseus's wedding day. If you will patiently dance in our round and join our moonlight revels, go with us. If not, shun me and I will spare your haunts.
Give me that boy, and I will go with thee.
Not for thy fairy kingdom. Fairies away! I shall chide downright if I longer stay.
Well, go thy way! Thou shalt not from this grove till I torment thee for this injury. My gentle Puck, come hither. Thou rememberest that charmed time I saw, but thou couldst not, flying between the cold moon and the earth. Cupid, all armed. A certain aim he took, and loosed his love shaft smartly from his bow, as it should pierce 100,000 hearts. Yet marked I where the bolt of Cupid fell. It fell upon a little western flower, before milk white, now purple with love's wound. And maidens call it love in idleness. Fetch me that flower, the herb I showed thee once. The juice of it on sleeping eyelids laid will make a man or woman madly dote upon the next live creature that it sees. Fetch me this herb, and be thou here again ere the Leviathan can swim a league.
Yeah, I'll put a girdle around the earth in 40 minutes. 40 minutes, yeah, okay. Nope, that way.
Having once this juice, I'll watch Titania while she is asleep and drop the liquor of it in her eyes. The next thing she waking looks upon, be it on lion, or bear, or wolf, or bull, she shall pursue it with the soul of love. And ere I take this charm from off her sight, I'll make her render up her page to me. But who comes here? I'm invisible, and will overhear their conference.
Demetrius!
I love thee not, therefore pursue me not. Where is Lysander and fair Hermia? Thou toldest me they were stolen into this wood, and here am I, and woed within this wood, because I cannot meet my Hermia. Hence get thee gone, and follow me no more. Do I entice you?
Oh, come on!
Do I speak you fair? Or rather, do I not in plainest truth tell you, I do not nor I cannot love you?
But even for that do I love you the more! I am your spaniel, and Demetrius, the more you beat me, I will fawn on you! Use me but as your spaniel. Spurn me, strike me, neglect me, lose me. Only give me leave, as unworthy as I am, to follow you.
Tempt not too much the hatred of my spirit, for I am sick when I do look on you.
And I am sick when I look not on you.
You do impeach your modesty too much to leave the city and commit yourself into the hands of one that loves you not, to trust the opportunity of night and a desert place with the rich worth of your virginity.
It is not night when I do see your face, therefore I think I am not in the night. Nor doth this wood lack worlds of company, for you in my respect are all the world.
I will not say thy questions. Let me go. Okay. Or if thou followest me, do not believe, but I shall do thee mischief in the woods.
Demetrius.
I'll run from thee, and hide me in the brakes, and leave thee to the mercy of wild beasts.
Oh, the wildest hath not such a heart as you! You do me mischief! Fie, Demetrius! Your wrongs do set a scandal on my sex. We cannot fight for love as men may do. We should be wooed, and we're not made to woo. So follow thee, and make a heaven of hell, to die upon the hands that I love so well.
Fare thee well, nymph. Ere he do leave this grove, thou shalt fly him, and he shall seek thy love. Welcome, wanderer, hast thou the flower there?
Oh, good grief. Yeah, there it is, yeah.
I pray thee give it me. I know a bank where the wild thyme blows, where ox lips and the nodding violet grows. There sleeps Titania some time of the night, lulled in these flowers with dances and delight. And with the juice of this, I'll streak her eyes and make her full of hateful fantasies. Take thou some of it, and seek through this grove. A sweet Athenian lady is in love with a disdainful youth. Anoint his eyes, but do it when the next thing he espies may be the lady. Thou shalt know the man by the Athenian garment he hath on.
Lady, fear not, my lord, your servant shall do so! Your servant shall do so! Oh my god, these people I work with.
Come now, a round and then a fairy song. Sing me now to sleep, then to your offices and let me rest.
When I feel blue in the night and I need you to hold me tight whenever I want you. All I have to do is dream, 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 dream.
Hence away.
Shh.
Now all is well. The moon aloof stands sentinel.
What thou seest when thou dost wake, do it for thy true love take. Be it hound or cat or bear, pard or boar with bristled hair, in thy eye that shall appear when thou wak'st, it is thy dear. Wake when some vile thing is near.
Oh, fair love, you faint with wandering in this wood.
Mm-hmm.
And to speak truth, I have forgot our way. We'll rest us, Hermia, if you think it good, and tarry for the comfort of the day.
Be it so, Lysander. Find you out of bed, for I upon this bank will rest my head.
Oh. One pair shall serve as pillow for us both. One heart, two bosoms, and one troth.
Nay, good Lysander, for my sake, my dear, lie further off yet. Do not lie so near.
No, I meant that my heart unto yours is knit, so that but one heart we can make of it.
Mm-hmm.
Then two bosoms interchange with an oath, so then two bosoms and a single troth. Then by your side no bedroom need deny. For lying so, Hermia, I do not lie.
Lysander, riddles very prettily, but much beshrew my manners and my pride if Hermia meant to say that Lysander lied. But, gentle friend, for love and courtesy, lie further off in human modesty. For such separation, as may well be said, becomes a virtuous bachelor and a maid. So far be distant, and good night, sweet friend. Thy love never alter till thy sweet life end.
Amen. Amen to that fair prayer, say I. And then end life when I end loyalty. Here is my bed.
Mm-hmm.
Sleep give thee all his rest.
And with half that wish, the wisher's eye be pressed.
Okay. through the forest have I gone, and Athenian found I none, on whose eyes I might approve this flower's force in stirring love. Night and silence. Oh, well, okay. Who is here? Weeds of Athens he doth wear. Oh, this is he, my master said, despised the Athenian maid. Oh, and hear the maiden. Oh, sleeping sound on the dank and dirty ground. Pretty soul. Oh, she durst not lie near this lack love, this kill courtesy. What? Churl. Upon thy eyes, I throw all the power this charm doth owe. When thou wakest, let love forbid sleep his seat on thy eyelid. Give it back. Thank you. So awake when I am gone, for I must now to Oberon.
Demetrius! Demetrius! Stay, though thou kill me, sweet Demetrius!
I charge thee hence, do not haunt me thus!
Oh, wilt thou, darkling, leave me? Do not so!
Stay on thy peril, I alone will go!
Oh, I am out of breath, Miss Fond Chase! The more is my prayer, the lesser is my grace! Happy is Hermia, wheresoever she lies, for she hath blessed and attractive eyes! No, no, I'm ugly as a bear, for beasts that meet me do run away with fear! But who is here? Lysander on the ground? Dead or alive? I see no blood, no wound. Lysander, if you live, good sir, awake? Awake? Hi.
And run through fire I will for thy sweet sake.
Huh?
Oh, transparent Helena, nature shows art that through thy bosom makes me see thy heart. Where is Demetrius?
Huh?
Oh, how fit a word, that vile name, to perish on my sword.
Do not say so, Lysander, say not so. What though he love your Hermia, lord? What though? Yet Hermia still loves you, so be content.
Content? With Hermia?
Yeah.
No.
Huh?
I do repent the tedious moments I with her have spent. Not Hermia, but Helena I love.
Oh.
Who will not change a raven for a dove?
Wherefore was I to this keen mockery born? When at your hand did I deserve this scorn? Is it not enough? Is it not enough, young man? That I never did, no, nor never can deserve a sweet look from Demetrius' eye, but you must flout my insufficiency? But fare you well. Perforce, I must confess I thought you more lord of true gentleness. Oh, the lady of one man refused must of another therefore be abused.
Well, would you look at that?
Huh? No!
Helena!
No!
Lysander? What? Removed? Lysander? Lord? Where are you? Speak, and if thou hear, speak of all loves. I swoon almost with fear. No. Then I perceive that you are not nigh. Either death or you will find immediately.
Convenient place for our rehearsal. This green plot shall be our stage, that hawthorn brake our tiring house, and we will do it in action as we will do it before the...
Madam Quince!
What sayest thou, Bully Bottom?
There are things in this comedy of Pyramus and Thisbe that will never please. First, Pyramus must draw a sword to kill himself, which the ladies... duh, cannot abide. What say you that?
Fire lake and a parlous fear.
Mm-hmm.
I believe we shall leave the killing out when all is done.
Not a whit! I have an advice to make all well. Write me a prologue, and let the prologue seem to say that we will do no harm with our swords, and that Pyramus is not killed indeed. And for more better assurance, tell them that I, Pyramus, and not really Pyramus, but I'm really Bottom the Weaver. This will put them out of their fears.
Will not the ladies be afeard of the lion?
Oh, I fear it. I promise you.
Yeah.
Well, and there are two more hard things. That is, to bring moonlight into a chamber. For Pyramus and Thisbe, as you know, meet by moonlight.
Ah! Doth the moon shine the night we play our play?
Oh, a calendar. Hey, look in the almanac. Find out moonshine.
No. Siri, doth the moon shine that night?
Yes, it doth shine that night.
Why, then the moon may shine in the casement.
Aye, or else one must come in with a lantern and say that he comes to present a person of moonshine. Oh, then there is another thing. We must have a wall, for Pyramus Thisbe, says the story, did talk through a chink in a wall.
Ah. What say you, Bottom?
Some man or woman must present wall, and that they hold their fingers thus, and through that cranny shall Pyramus and Thisbe whisper.
If that may be, then all is well. Come, down every mother's son and rehearse your parts.
Oh, what hempen homespuns have we swaggering here? Oh, so near the cradle of the fairy queen.
Well, speak, Pyramus. Thisbe, stand forth.
Thisbe, the flowers of odious savor sweet.
Odors.
Odors. Savor sweet, so hath thy breath, my dearest Thisbe dear. But hark, a voice! Stay but here a while, and by I will to thee appear.
A stranger Pyramus than e'er played here.
Thisbe.
What?
Thisbe?
Must I speak now?
Aye, marry, you must, for you must understand, he but goes to see the noise that he heard and will come again.
Most radiant Pyramus, most lily-white of hue, with color of red rose on triumphant briar, most frisky juvenile and eke most lovely jewel, as true as horse that yet would never tire, I meet thee, Pyramus, at Ninny's tomb.
Ninus's tomb, ma'am. And you must not say that yet. That is an answer to Pyramus. Well, you speak your lines all at once, cues and all. Huh. Pyramus, enter. Your cue is never tire.
As true as horse that yet would never tire.
If I were fair, Thisbe, I'm only thine. Why do they run away from me? I see their knavery. This is to make an ass of me, to fright me if they could. But I will not stir from this place. Do what they can. I walk up and down, and I shall sing that they shall know that I am not afraid. Making my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart, bump, bump, bump. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. 2, 3, 4. They say I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. But life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. But that's fine by me.
Oh, what? Angel wakes me from my flowery bed. Oh, I prithee, gentle mortal,
sing again. For mine ear is much enamored of thy note, so is mine eye enthralled to thy shape. Oh, and thy fair virtue's force, perforce doth move me on the first view to say, to swear, I love thee.
Methinks, m'lady, that you should have little reason for that. And to speak truth, love and reason keep little company together nowadays.
Oh, thou art as wise as thou art beautiful.
Not so neither. If I have enough wit to get out of this wood, I would have enough to serve my own turn.
Out of this wood, do not desire to go. Thou shalt remain here, whether thou wilt or no. I am a spirit of no common rate. The summer still doth tend upon my state. Oh, and I do love thee. Therefore, go with me. I'll give thee fairies to attend on thee, and they shall fetch thee jewels from the deep, and sing while thou on pressed flowers doth sleep. Peas blossom, cobweb, moth, mustard seed.
Ready!
And I!
And I!
Where shall we go?
Oh.
Hi.
Come, wait upon him. Lead him to my bower. The moon, methinks, looks with a watery eye, and when she weeps, weeps every little flower, lamenting some enforced chastity. Tie up my lover's tongue. Lead him silently. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. Our long last love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
I wonder if Titania be awake. Then what it was that next came in her eye that she must dote on in extremity. How now, mad spirit? What night rule now about this haunted grove?
my mistress with a monster is in love. Oh, yeah. Near to her close and consecrated bower, a crew of patches, rude mechanicals, were met together to rehearse a play, all intended for a great Theseus' nuptial day. The shallowest thick skin of that barren sort, who Pyramus presented in their sport, forsook his scene and entered in a break, when I did him at this advantage take. An ass's nose, I fixed it on his head. Oh, anon his Thisbe must be answered. Then forth my mimic comes, when they him spy thus at our stamp. Here o'er and o'er and o'er one falls, oh, he murder cries, and help from Athens calls. I led them on in this distracted fear, and left sweet Pyramus translated there. When in that moment, so it came to pass that Titania waked, and straightway loved an ass.
Oh, this falls out better than I could devise. Oh, but hast thou yet latched the Athenian's eyes with the love juice as I bid thee do?
Oh, yeah, I took him sleeping. That's finished too. And the Athenian woman by his side, that when he wakes, of course, she must be eyed.
Oh. Oh, that close. This is that same Athenian.
This is the woman. Not this the man.
Oh, why rebuke you him that loves you so?
If thou hast slain Lysander in his sleep, be it o'ershoes, and plunge in the deep, and kill me too. The sun was not so true unto the day as he to me. Would he have stolen away from sleeping Hermia? It cannot be, but thou hast murdered him. So a murderer should look, So dead, so grim.
So should the murdered look, and so should I. Pierce to the heart with your stern cruelty. You spend your passions on a misprized mood. I am not guilty of Lysander's blood, nor is he dead for aught that I can tell.
I pray thee, then tell me that he is well.
And if I could, what should I get therefor?
A privilege. Never to see me more!
There is no following her in this fierce vein. I will remain, so sorrow's heaviness doth heavier grow, for debt that bankrupt sleep doth sorrow owe, which now in some slight measure it will pay, if for this tender here I make some stay.
What hast thou done? Thou hast mistaken quite, and laid the love juice on some true love's sight.
Oh my God.
About the wood, go swifter than the wind.
No, 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 no,
and
no, no, no.
Helena of Athens, look thou fine. All fancy 6 years and pale of cheer, with sighs of love that cost the fresh blood dear. By some illusion, see thou bring her here. I'll charm his eye against she do appear.
All right, I go. Look how I go! Swifter than an arrow from the Tartar's bow.
Boss. Flower of this purple dye, hit with Cupid's archery, sink in apple of his eye. When his love he doth espy, let her shine as gloriously as the Venus of the sky. When thou wak'st, if she be by, beg of her for remedy.
Captain, of our fairy band, hold on. Oh, God. Let's go. Oh, Tartar's bow just around. Oh. Okay. Helena is here at hand, and the youth mistook by me, pleading for a lover's fee. Oh, shall we bear fond pageancy? Oh, Lord. What fools these mortals be.
Why should you think I should woo in scorn? Oh, scorn and derision never come in tears. Look, when I vow, I weep, and vow so born in their nativity all truth appears.
These vows are Hermia's. Will you give her over?
I had no judgment when to her I swore.
No, not in my mind that you give her over.
Oh. Oh, Helen.
Hi.
Goddess, nymph, perfect, divine, to what, my love, shall I compare thine eye? Crystal is muddy. Oh, how ripe thy lips, those kissing cherries tempting grow. When thou holdest up thy hand, let me kiss this princess of pure white, this seal of bliss.
Oh, spite! Oh, hell! I see you're bent to set against me for your merriment! You both are rivals and love Hermia, and now rivals to mock Helena? A trim exploit, a manly enterprise to conjure tears up in a poor maid's eyes with your derision. None of a noble sort would so offend a virgin ought to make their sport.
Demetrius, you are unkind. Be not so, for you love Hermia. This you know, I know. And here, with all goodwill, with all my heart, in Hermia's love, I yield you up my part, and yours of Helena to me bequeath, whom I do love and will do to my death.
Lysander, keep thy Hermia, I will none. If ever I loved her, all that love is gone. My heart to her, but is guestwise sojourned, and now to Helen. It is home returned, there to remain.
Helen, it is not so.
Lysander!
Look where thy love comes, yonder is thy dear.
Lysander, thou art not by my eyes found, my ear I think it brought me to thou sound. But why, unkindly, did thou leave me so?
Why should he stay whom love doth press to go?
Well, love could press Lysander from my side.
Lysander's love, who would not let him bide. Fair Helena, who more engilds the night than all yon fiery oaths and eyes of light. Why seekest thou me? Could not this make thee know? The hate I bear thee made me leave thee so.
You speak not as you think, it cannot be.
Lo! She is one of this confederacy! Now I perceive they have conjoined all three to fashion this false sport in spite of me. Injurious Hermia, most ungrateful maid! Is all the counsel that we two have shared, the sisters' vows, the time we have spent together when we have chid the hasty-footed time for parting us? Oh, is all forgot? And will you rent our ancient love asunder to join with men in scorning your poor friend?
I scorn you not. It seems that you scorn me.
Have you not set Lysander as in scorn to follow me and praise my eyes and face and make your other love Demetrius with him but now to spurn me with his foot to call me goddess, nymph, divine, rare, precious, celestial? Wherefore he speaks, sister, her he hates. And wherefore doth Lysander deny your love so rich within his soul and tender me? Forsooth, affection, but by your setting on, by your consent.
I understand not what you mean by this.
Fare you well. 'Tis partly mine own fault, which death or absence soon shall remedy.
No, stay gentle, Helena. Hear my excuse, my love, my life, my soul, fair Helena.
I say I love thee more than he can do.
If thou say so, withdraw and prove it too.
Quick, come.
No! Lysander, where to tend all this?
Hang off, thou cat, thou burr, vile thing let loose, or I will shake thee from me like a serpent.
Do you not jest?
Yes, sooth, and so do you.
Am I not, Hermia? Are you not Lysander? I am as fair now as I was erewhile.
Be certain, nothing truer. 'Tis no jest that I do hate thee. Love Helena.
Oh, me. You.
Huh?
Puppet! You cave of blossom, you thief of love! What have you come by night and stolen my love's heart from him?
Finite faith! Have you no modesty?
Oh, yes.
No maiden shame? What will you tear impatient answers from my gentle tongue? Fie, fie, you counterfeit, you puppet, you!
Puppet? Uh-huh. Now I perceive that she has made compare between our heights.
Oh.
And with her personage, her tall personage, her height forsooth, she hath prevailed with him. Are you grown so high in his esteem? Because I am so dwarfish and so low? Well, how low am I, thou painted maple? Speak! How low am I? I am not yet so low, but that my nails can reach into thine eyes! Come on!
No! I pray you, though you mock me, gentlemen, let her not hurt me. You perhaps may think because she is something lower than myself that I can match her.
Lower heart again!
Good Hermia, do not be so bitter with me. I evermore did love you, Hermia. And now, so you will let me quiet go back to Athens, will I bear my folly back and follow you no further. Just let me go.
Why get you gone? Who is it that hinders you?
A foolish heart that I leave here behind.
What with Lysander?
She was a vixen when we went to school. And though she be but little, she is fierce.
Little? Again? Nothing but low and little? Why will you suffer her to flout me thus?
Get you gone, you dwarf, you bead, you acorn.
You are too officious in her behalf that scorns your services. Let her alone.
You, mistress, all this coil is in long of you? Nay, go not back.
I will not trust you, I, nor longer stay in your cursed company. Your hands than mine are quicker for fray, but my legs are longer, though, to run away!
Wait, Helen, come back!
I am amazed. I know not what to say. Lysander!
This is thy negligence. Still thou mistakest, or else commits thy knaveries willfully.
Oh, okay. Oh, forgive me, O King of Shadows. I mistook. Huh? Did you not tell me that I should know the man by the Athenian garments he had on? And so far am I glad it so did sort, as this there jangling, I have seen their sport.
Thou seest these lovers seek a place to fight.
Yeah.
Hie therefore, Robin, overcast the night, and lead these testy rivals so astray as one come not within another's way. And from each other, look thou lead them thus, till o'er their brows death counterfeiting sleep, with leaden legs and batty wings doth creep. Then crush this herb into Lysander's eye, whose liquor hath this virtuous property, to take from thence all errors with his might, and make his eyeballs roll with wonted sight. When next they awake, all this derision shall seem a dream and fruitless vision. Whilst I in this affair do thee employ, I'll to my queen and beg her changeling boy. And then I will her charmed eye release from monster's view, and all things shall be peace.
Up and down, up and down. Oh, I will lead them up and down. I am feared in field and town. Oh, goblin, lead them up and down. Ooh, here comes one.
Where art thou, proud Demetrius? Speak thou now.
Here, villain. Drawn and ready, ready, ready. Where art thou?
I will be with thee straight.
And to plainer ground.
When I come where he calls, then he is gone. The villain is much lighter heeled than I. I followed fast, but faster he did fly. Yet here will I rest me. For if but once thou show me thy great light, I'll find Demetrius and revenge this spite.
Ugh, Lysander, speak again. Thou coward, thou runaway, art thou fled?
How, coward? Why comest thou not?
Thou runnest before me, shifting every place, and darest not stand nor look me in the face.
Come hither. I am here. I am here. I am here.
Nay, then thou mockest me. Thou shalt buy this dear, if ever I thy face by daylight see. Now go thy way.
Oh, weary night, oh, long and tedious night, abate thy hours. Shine comforts from the east that I may back to Athens by daylight from these that my poor company detest. Oh, and sleep. Sometimes shuts up a sorrow's eye. Steal me a while from mine own company.
Never so weary, never so in woe. I can no further crawl, no further go. My legs cannot keep a pace with my desires. Here I will rest me till the break of day. Heaven shield Lysander if they mean a fray.
Huh. Okay. On the ground, sleep sound. I'll apply to your eye, gentle lover, remedy. When thou wakest, thou takest true delight in the sight of thy former lady's eye.
I love you, baby.
Down upon this flowery bed, while I thy amiable cheeks do coy and stick musk roses in thy sleek, smooth head and kiss thy fair, large ears, my gentle joy.
Where's Mistress Peace Blossom?
Ready.
Oh, scratch my hand, Mistress Peace Blossom. And where's Madame Cobweb?
Ready.
Oh, Madame Cobweb, get your weapons in hand and kill me a red-hipped humblebee on top of a thistle. Mm-hmm. And where my lady's moth and mustard seed?
What is your will?
Nothing but to have Mistress Peace Blossom to scratch. You know, I must go to the barber soon, for I am marvelous hairy about the face. And I am such a tender ass that if my hair do but tickle, I must scratch.
Oh, say, sweet love, what dost thou desirest to eat?
Truly, I could go for your good dried oats. Oh, methinks I have a great desire for some bottled hay. Oh, good hay, sweet. Hath no fellow.
I shall send a venturous fairy then to seek the squirrel's hoard and fetch thee thence new nuts.
Yeah, but I pray you, let none of you people stir me, for I have an exposition of sleep come upon me.
Sleep now, and I will wind thee in my arms. Oh, how I love thee. How I dote on thee.
Welcome, good Robin. Seest thou this sweet sight? Her dotage now I do begin to pity. I will undo this hateful imperfection of her eyes. And, gentle Puck, take that transformed scalp from off the head of that Athenian swain, that he, awaking when the other do, may all to Athens back again repair. And think no more of this night's accidents, but as the fierce vexation of a dream. But first, I will release the Fairy Queen. Be as thou wast wont to be. See as thou wast wont to see. Now, my Titania. Wake you, my sweet queen! Nyah!
Oh, my Oberon, oh, what visions have I seen? Oh, methought I was enamored of an ass.
There lies your love.
How came these things to pass?
Come, my queen, come fly with me, and rock the ground whereon these sleepers be.
Come, my lord. And in our flight, tell me how it came this night that I, sleeping here, was found with these mortals on the ground.
To the mountain's top to mark the musical confusion of hounds and echo in conjunction.
But soft, what nymphs are these?
My lord, this is my daughter here asleep. This is Lysander. This Demetrius is. This Helena, old Nedar's Helena, I wonder of their being here together.
Good morrow, friends. St. Valentine is past. Begin these wood birds but to couple now?
Pardon, my lord.
Oh, I pray you all stand up. Now, you two, I know, are rival enemies. How come this gentle concord in the world, that hatred is so far from jealousy, to sleep by hate and fear no enmity?
My lord, I shall reply. Amazedly, half asleep, half waking, but as I think, for truly what I speak, I cannot truly say how I came here. But now do I bethink me, so it is. I came with Hermia hither. Our intent was to be gone from Athens, where we might, without the peril of the Athenian law...
Enough, my lord. You have enough. I beg the law. The law upon his head. They would have stolen away. They would have, Demetrius, thereby to have defeated you and me, you of your wife, me of my consent. Of my consent that she be your wife.
My lord, fair Helen told me of their stealth, of this their purpose hither to this wood. And I, in fury, followed them, fair Helen in fancy following me. But my lord, I wot not by what power, but by some power it is. My love for Hermia melted as the snow seems to me now as the remembrance of an idol god. And now all the faith, the virtue of my heart, the object and pleasure of mine eye, is only Helen. To her, my lord, was I betrothed ere I saw Hermia. But like a sickness did I loathe this food. But as in health come to my natural taste, now do I wish it, love it, long for it, and
will forevermore be true to it.
Well, fair lovers, you are fortunately met. Aegeus, I'll bear your will. For in the temple, by and by, with us, these couples shall eternally be knit.
Away with us to Athens, 3 and 3. We'll hold a feast in great solemnity. Come, Hippolyta.
Methinks I see things with a parted eye when everything seems double.
So methinks. And I have found Demetrius, like a jewel, mine own and not mine own.
Are you sure we are awake? It seems to me that yet we sleep, we dream. Do you not think the Duke was here and bid us follow him?
Yea, and my father.
And Hippolyta.
And he did bid us follow him to the temple.
Then we are awake. Let us follow him. And by the way, let us recount our dreams.
When my cue has come, call me, and I will answer. My answer is most fair, Pyramus, hi-ho. Peter Quince? Flute the Bellsmender? Snug the Joiner? Starveling! God's my life. Stolen hence, and left me asleep? I have had a vision. I've had a dream. Past the wit of man to say what this dream was. Man is but an ass if you go about to expound this dream. Methought I was... There's no man can say what. Methought I was. And methought I had. But man is but a pack fool if he will offer to say what methought I had. Huh. The eyes of man hath not heard. The ears of man hath not seen. Man's hand to taste, the tongue to conceive. Nor the heart to say what my dream was. I will get Peter Quince or Madam Quince to write me a ballad of this dream, and it shall be called Bottom's Dream, because, woo, it hath no bottom. And I will sing it at the letter and half of a play before the Duke. Ho, 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 Nicholas Bottom, you have done it again, woo!
Yet.
He cannot be heard of. Out of doubt, he is transported.
If he come not, then the play is marred. It goes not forward, doth it?
No.
He hath simply the best wit of any handicraftsman in Athens.
And the best person, too.
And it is a very paramour for a sweet voice.
Masters, the Duke is coming from the temple, and there is 2 or 3 lords and ladies more married. If our sport had gone forward, we had all been made men.
Oh, sweet Bully Bottom.
Where are these lads? Where are the turks?
Oh, Bottom! Oh, most courageous day, most happy hour!
Masters, masters, masters! I am to discourse wonders. I will tell you everything, ready to spell out.
Let us hear, sweet Bottom.
All I am to say is that the Duke hath dined. Get your apparel together. Meet presently at the palace. Every man look over his part, for the short and long is that our play is preferred. Yeah, in any case, Thisbe, have clean linen, and let not he who plays the lion pair his nails. And most of your actors, eat no onions or garlic, for we are utter sweet, sweet, sweet breath. And I do not doubt but to hear them say, it is a sweet comedy. No more words. Away. Go away.
When we were younger, we thought everyone was on our side. Then we grew a little and romanticized the time I saw flowers in your hair. It takes a boy to live, it takes a man to pretend he was there.
So now
I
I think that I could love you back. And I hope it's not too late, cause you're so attractive. And the way you move, I won't close my eyes. It takes a man to live, but it takes a woman to make him compromise. Me and my eyes, me and my heart.
Oh, here are the lovers, full of joy and mirth. Joy, gentle friends, joy and fresh days of love accompany your hearts.
Well, come, what masks, what dances shall we have to wear away this long age of 3 hours between our after supper and bedtime? What devils are in hand, is there no play to ease the anguish of a torturing hour? I'll illustrate.
What?
yeah, here, mighty Hippolyta. Yeah, come on.
Okay, what abridgment have you for this evening? What mask? What music?
Here is a brief of what sports are ripe. Make a choice of what your highness shall see first.
A tedious brief scene of young Pyramus and his love Thisbe. Very tragical mirth. Merry and tragical, tedious and brief.
That is hot ice and wondrous strange snow.
We will hear it.
My lord, it's not for you. I've heard it over. It's nothing. Nothing in the world to do you service.
I will hear that play. For never anything can be amiss when simpleness and duty tender it. So bring them in and take your places, ladies.
Partition ever I heard, my lord.
Pyramus draws near the wall. Silence.
Oh, grim luck, knight! Oh, knight with hue so black! Oh, knight! Oh, knight! Alack! 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 I fear my Thisbe's promise is forgot, and thou, oh, wall. Oh, sweet, lovely wall, that stands between her father's ground and mine! Thou wall, ho, wall, oh, sweet, lovely wall, show me thine chink to blink through with mine eye. But what see I? No Thisbe do I see! Oh! Wicked wall, through whom I see no bliss! Curse thy stone for thus deceiving me!
Well, yeah, the wall, methinks, being sensible, should curse again.
No! In truth, deceiving me is Thisbe's cue. She is to enter now, and I am to spy her through the wall. I am a full pat, as I told you.
Oh, wall! For often hast thou hurt my mouth for pardoning my fair Pyramus and me!
I see a voice? Hey, now will I to the wall.
Thisbe!
My love! Thou art my love, I think!
Oh, kiss me through the hole of this thy wall!
I kiss the wall's hole, not your lips at all!
Oh, wilt thou at Ninny's to meet me straight away?
Tide life! Tide death! I come without delay!
Thus have I, wall, my part discharged so, and being done, thus wall away doth go.
This is the silliest stuff that ever I heard.
Here come in two noble beasts, a man and a lion.
You, ladies, you whose gentle hearts do fear the smallest monstrous mouse that creeps on floor, may now perchance both quake and tremble here when lion, rough in wildest rage, doth roar. Then know that I, one snug the joiner am. No lion's fell, nor else no lion's dam.
A very gentle beast, and of a good conscience. Mm.
Mm-hmm. This lantern doth the horn moon present. I myself, the man in the moon, do seem to be.
Well, this is the greatest error of all the rest. The man should be in the lantern. How else is the man in the moon?
No, proceed, moon.
Well, all that I have to say is that the lantern is the moon. I myself, the man in the moon. This thorn bush is my thorn bush. And this dog, this is my dog. This is my dog.
Don't, but silence! Here comes Thisbe.
This is old Minnie's tomb. Where is my love?
Of a surgeon, he may yet recover and prove an ass.
Oh, I hope she will not use a lot. speech for such a Pyramus. I hope she will be brief.
Asleep, my love? What's dead, my dove? O Pyramus, arise! Speak, speak! Quite dumb? Dead! A tomb must cover thy sweet eyes! These lily lips, this cherry nose, and these yellow cowslip cheeks are gone! Are gone! Lovers, make moan!
Oh.
His eyes are as green as leeks! Sisters three, come to me with hands as pale as milk! Lay them in gore, for you have sore with tears and blood of silk! Tongue! Not a word! Come, trusty sword! Come, blade, my rust and brew!
And Lion are left to bury the dead.
I and Wall too.
No! No, no. Mm-hmm. I assure you, the wall is down that part of their fathers. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's down. Mm-hmm. We'll please you to see the epilogue.
Oh, no, no!
No epilogue, I pray you, for your play needs no excuse. Never excuse for when the players are all dead. There needs none to be blamed.
Well, the iron tongue of midnight hath told 12. Lovers, to bed! It is almost fairy time. This palpable gross play hath well beguiled the heavy gold of night. Sweet friends, to bed! A fortnight hold we this reveling and new reveling and happy jollity.
If we shadows have offended, ah, well, think but this, and all is mended. Well, that you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear, and this weak and idle theme, oh, no more yielding but a dream. Oh, gentles, do not reprehend. Well, if you pardon, we will mend. Oh, and as I am an honest Puck, if we have unearned luck now to scape the serpent's tongue, we shall make amends ere long. Else, the Puck a liar call. So, good night unto you all. Oh, give me your hands if we be friends, huh? And Robin shall restore amends.